blessed us today. Hallelujah. The Lord has blessed us today. You know, when you wake up, hallelujah, you thank him, hallelujah, because he has given you a blessing. He's given you his breath that you can breathe into your lungs. Hallelujah. He's given us life and life more abundantly. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Today is Pentecost Sunday. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I just want to speak a little today about this festival, which started on Thursday night. It is called the Festival of Weeks, the Feast of the First Fruits. You see, exactly 7 weeks ago, we celebrated Passover. The Passover, which we read from Exodus, that we read in Genesis. Hallelujah, the Passover. Hallelujah. How many know that the Passover lamb is our Savior, Jesus the Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach. He is the Passover lamb. So now we're exactly 7 weeks past Passover. Amen. So now,
amen.
Hallelujah. So we're celebrating the Feast of the First Fruits. In Hebrew, it's Habikurim. Habikurim. Say that. Habikurim. It is the feast. Yes, Kurim. It is the first fruits. Hallelujah. How many know that we shall offer up our first fruits to the Lord? You see, we work all week. We get paid. But those first fruits need to go up to the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Also, another name for Habikurim is Shavuot. Shavuot, which means weeks. Shavua means weeks. Right, means weeks. Now, it also means the day of Pentecost. Hallelujah. So you see, I'm going to speak today a little about the Old Testament, the New Testament, the Jew and the Gentile. Because one day they will all become one under Christ Jesus, Jew and Gentile.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, hallelujah. It says in Exodus 19:1, in the third month, after the children of Israel had gone out of the land of Egypt, on the same day they came to the wilderness of Sinai. Okay, so basically 7 weeks after they had left Egypt, after they passed over, amen, after they passed through the sea, the Red Sea, hallelujah, it exactly 7 weeks after they left Egypt. Now, 7 is the number of completion, the number of perfection. I always speak about it because it's probably my favorite number, amen. After the Lord had created on the 6th day, he rested on the 7th day. This is the 7th day, means the day of perfection, the day of completion. It also completes our week, right? The end of the week is the 7th day. Now, if you do 7 times 7, it equals 49, right? So exactly 7 weeks after Passover, Moses had another encounter. You see, he had an encounter with the burning bush, but then he had another encounter 7 weeks later. And on Mount Sinai, where he had an encounter before with the burning bush. Wow. So the same mountain that he had the first encounter, he went to the mountain again for a second time, and he had another encounter. There, God instructed him to get the people ready to consecrate themselves. Consecrate means to be holy, that you be clean, that you have a pure heart and clean hands, to consecrate themselves. Wash the clothes and be ready for the first fruits. Exodus 19 to 16, hallelujah, it says, Exodus 19, verse 16. And it came to pass on the third day in the morning that there were thunders and lightnings and a thick cloud upon the mound, and the voice of a trumpet exceedingly loud, so that all the people that was in the camp trembled. You see, all that was in the camp trembled because they heard the thunder, the lightning, and then the sound of a trumpet, the shofar. My God, a supernatural shofar. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And on Mount Sinai, they were all together on a smoke because the Lord descended upon it in fire. You see, the Lord came like fire. Hallelujah. Pentecost, hallelujah. Fire, 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 fire fall on me. Fire, 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 fire fall on me. On the day of Pentecost, the fire fell on me. Hallelujah. So the Lord descended on that mountain of Sinai, fire. Hallelujah. Then the first fruits were given. So now we're counting 7 weeks after Passover. 7 times 7 is 49. Okay. Now, Pentecost, or Pent, is in Greek, which means 50. 50th, right? So basically it was the 50th day. Then the first fruits were given in the Old Testament. Hallelujah. How many know that you cannot have the new if you don't have first the old? This is the Old Testament, the Torah, the truth, the instructions that the Lord gave to Moses. Amen? Then the first fruits were given. I am the Lord, thy God, which has brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Hallelujah. You see, there's still some people that are in Egypt. Till this day, they are in bondages. But we need to come out of Egypt. Hallelujah. Because who the Son sets free, we are free indeed. Who is the Son? Jesus the Christ. Hallelujah. He sent his only begotten Son for us to pay the price for us. I am the Lord God that has brought you out of bondage.
Amen.
This is when he gave Moses the Ten Commandments. Okay? So, 7 weeks after Passover, he gave instructions. He gave the law. Hallelujah. The Ten Commandments. Commandment number one was, no other gods before me. Number two, shall not make any graven images that is in heaven. Number three, shall not take the name of your Lord God in vain.
Jesus.
My God. Four, remember the Sabbath, keep it holy.
Yes, Lord.
Number five, honor your father and mother. You see how he put that first? The father first, then the mother. Hallelujah. He is our father. We shall obey him always first. Hallelujah. Number six, thou shalt not kill. Number seven, thou shalt not commit adultery. Number eight, thou shalt not steal. Number nine, thou shalt not bear false witness or commit lies. Number 10, thou shalt not covet. You shall not be jealous and try to get other people's anointings. Amen?
Amen.
Now, after all of this, the people were waiting for Moses for a long time. You see, when he went up, Moses went up to the Mount Sinai to speak with the Lord. The Lord was giving him instructions. He was instructing Moses to build the tabernacle. He was given the blueprints how to build this tabernacle. So the people gathered together with Aaron. Hallelujah. As this was happening, the instructions or the blueprints of the tabernacle, the people got together with Aaron. My God. And this is what they did. They created a golden calf. When Moses came down from the mountain, he seen that they were worshiping this golden calf. He got angry. He threw the two tablets of stone. My God. And he burnt the golden calf. He was outraged. He was so angry. He burned that golden calf to the ground. It turned into powder. And the water, hallelujah, when they were putting the fire out, that water, he made the children of Israel to drink that water. Wow. Wow. And then Moses stood in front of the camp and asked, "Who is on the Lord's side?" He went in front of the camp, actually saying, "Who is on the Lord's side to come next to him?" The sons of Levi came together with him. And Moses said to them, "Every man put his sword by his side and go in and out from gate to gate throughout the camp and kill every man, his brother, every man, his companion, every man, his neighbor, and the children of the Levi," or the Levites, "did accordingly to the word of Moses and their fellow of people that day." That day, their fellow people, 3,000 died, or 3,000 were killed. That number is significant, 3,000. Remember that number, right? Amen. Hallelujah. So basically, the law was written, but the law was, it wasn't taken into them, because they were already made another god. Already they were worshiping another god. And then it says, "Do not, you shall not kill." And boom, they killed. They killed 3,000 men, women, and children on that day, in one day. Hallelujah. The first fruits in the New Testament. So now the question is, did they celebrate Shavuot, or the Feast of the First Fruits, in the New Testament? The answer is yes. So, the first fruits in the New Testament, it was a supernatural power on Shavuot, the day of Pentecost. Now, we remembered, right, 7 weeks after the Passover, Moses received the law. Amen? Now, 7 weeks after the crucifixion of Yeshua, Jesus, where he died on the cross, he rose on the third day. It's 7 weeks after the Passover lamb was crucified and he rose on the third day. Hallelujah. So, seven again is the number of perfection, the number of completion. 7 times 7 is 49. Hallelujah. The day of Pentecost was the 50th day after the Lord had been crucified. Amen. You see where it ties into the Old Testament. Hallelujah. You see that word of God never returns void. Hallelujah. The prophecy of the Bible. Hallelujah. It always comes to fruition. Hallelujah. And being assembled together with them, he commanded them not to depart from Jerusalem. This is Yeshua speaking. But to wait for the promise of the Father, which, he said, "You have heard from me, for John truly baptized with water, but you shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now." That is Acts chapter 1, verse 4 and 5. Acts chapter 1, verse 9 says, "When he had spoken these things, while they watched, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight." So when he was speaking these things, our Lord and Savior was taken up into a cloud. Remember in the Old Testament, it spoke about the cloud that covered that mountain. Hallelujah. Now, when he had spoken these things, he was taking up into a cloud. And they couldn't understand, where did he go? What is going on? They were all amazed. The apostles, the disciples, the students of God, where they had studied under him 3.5 years, where they seen when he was crucified. Then they had the testimony that he resurrected on the third day. Of course, there was one that doubted, but the one that doubted did believe when he saw the nail piercings in his hand and on his feet. Hallelujah. Then they returned to Jerusalem from the mount they call Olivet, or the Mount of Olives, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day journey. Hallelujah. Then they had a vigil. It was called the Upper Room Prayer. It was a vigil. It was all night praying and fasting. It was all night praying and fastings. Hallelujah. And then when the day of Pentecost had fully come, they were all one accord in one place in that upper room. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled the whole house where they were sitting. Then there appeared to them divided tongues as of fire, and one sat upon each of them. So the rushing wind came in, just like at the Mount of Sinai. There was thundering, there was lightnings, that sound of the shofar. Hallelujah. Right here they received the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. It was fire. Hallelujah. And they were speaking other languages, different types of, I was going to say idiomas, or different types of dialects. Hallelujah. And there was the dwelling in Jerusalem. There were many devoted men to the scriptures from every nation and every tongue. And the sound occurred. The multitude came together, and they were confused, because everyone heard them speak in his own language. They were amazed, because the Medes were speaking Arabic, others were speaking Hebrew, others were speaking Galilean. Excuse me. Others were speaking different languages. They couldn't understand it. And then it said, whatever could this mean? Others were mocking, saying, they are full of new wine. So basically, they thought they were drunk. But realize that this was an all-night meeting. It was an all-night vigil. They were fasting and praying. You see, when you fast and you pray, when you can come together in one accord, this powerful, this supernatural power comes out. Hallelujah. But Peter, standing up with the 11, raised his voice and said to them, men of Judea and all who dwell in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and heed my words. For these are not drunk, as you suppose, since it is only the third hour of the day. Now the third hour of the day, it's 9 o'clock in the morning. Unless they were drinking wine all night. But no, they were fasting and they were praying. They were all in one accord. 9 o'clock in the morning this happened. Hallelujah. When they received the first fruits. Hallelujah. This was the first fruits that the Lord had given. Hallelujah. The disciples, the apostles. Hallelujah. And it shall come to pass that whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Hallelujah. Peter spoke this. Hallelujah. Then, hallelujah, Peter gave a sermon. Hallelujah. He gave a sermon and he began to just speak about the goodness of God. He spoke about the resurrection and the life. He spoke about how they were under his studies, the 12, and how these things they seen with their own eyes. And then he said, this is Jesus, God who has raised up, of which we are all witnesses. Therefore, being exalted to the right hand of God, and having received from the Father the promise of the Holy Spirit. You see, the Lord, before he went up, he promised that something will be given, the first fruits. He poured out this which you now see and hear. Hallelujah. And with many other words, he testified and exhorted them. Amen. Exhorted them, saying, be saved from this perverse generation. Then those who gladly received his word were baptized. And that day, about, it's the same scripture that we read in the Old Testament, when about 3,000 were killed, or 3,000 died. But this is the New Testament, hallelujah. This is the New Testament, and it says, on that day, about 3,000 souls were added to them. 3,000 souls were saved. Hallelujah. You see, without the old, you can't have the new. Hallelujah. You see, in the old was the law. Hallelujah. But now we're in the new. We're in the age of his grace and his mercy. His mercy endureth forever. Hallelujah. And his grace is sufficient for us. And it is renewed every day. Not only this day of Pentecost, every day. So you see, 3,000 souls were added to them. 3,000 souls were saved. Hallelujah. And in the beginning, in the Old Testament, 3,000 souls were killed because they didn't obey. They didn't obey the Lord. Amen. So you see how this comes together, hallelujah, the old with the new, hallelujah. And yes, we don't have to sacrifice bulls or bullocks or oxes or sheep, because the sacrificial lamb has been crucified over 2,000 years ago. His name is Yeshua. His name is the Savior. His name is Jesus, hallelujah. And we thank you, Father, hallelujah, that you sent your only and your only begotten Son for us, hallelujah, to die on that cross, to bleed, to take those stripes for us, that we can be renewed, that we can have a new life, that we can have everlasting life, hallelujah. So, Father, I thank you, Lord, for the Son, and we bless the Holy Spirit today. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit of God. Hallelujah. It is the day of Pentecost, 50 days after the Lord was crucified.
Amen.
Amen. In the beginning, it was 50 days after the Passover, where the Lord gave the Ten Commandments to Moses. So you have the law, hallelujah, the Mosaic law, hallelujah, and you have now his grace and his mercy.
Amen.
So we thank the Lord, hallelujah. Shalom, everyone. Be
Shalom.
Blessed, hallelujah. Rejoice Shalom. In the Lord today, for he is worthy to be praised,
yes.
Hallelujah. Amen.